10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0.
Oh, horror peeps, and welcome to another season of Horror Addicts. I am super excited about this season, you guys, because the powers that be have made it their mission to increase the amount of cultural horror that we are showcasing on our page by 80%. And I, for one, am over the moon about this. Now, for those of you guys who follow me here or on my YouTube channel or anywhere on social media, already know that I have always brought a lot of diversity to my content because I like international films. So I'm sharing movies with you guys that I think that you would enjoy. But now with the whole staff dedicated to bringing you guys more diverse horror and more cultural horror, it's just gonna be so much more amazing because all of us across the board are going to be bringing you, films and movies and books and that are way more diverse than what you may have seen in the previous season. So I'm super excited about that. I'm super, super excited about that. So when it was first announced, what I did over the summer, I mean, not the summer, but on our off season, so that I guess that's kind of like the horror addict summer, like when, in between seasons. What I did is I scoured the globe and I put together a list of movies that I think that you guys are going to love. So I'm super excited about this season. And the first movie I'm gonna be watching you guys for tonight comes out of Sweden. The trailer is off the chain. When I watched the trailer, I knew that I was gonna watch this movie, so I didn't read any reviews. I didn't watch any review videos. I was just like, absolutely yes. I put it aside, and every time I see it pop up, I'm like, no, because I don't wanna, I just want this to be, I wanna go into this with a blank slate with no predetermined ideas. The movie I'm going to be watching for you guys tonight is called Koko-di-Koko-da. And like I said, it comes out of Sweden. So watch this insane trailer. And if you want to see what I think, stick around. Okay, you guys, let's get into this.
Det här är faktiskt min semester. Jag vill kunna koppla av på min semester.
Aha. Vad har vi här?
Du måste dra!
Koko-di-Koko-da.
Rolig nu. Vi vil jo bare lege det.
What did she eat? Oh my god, she looks fucking horrible. So she's allergic to shellfish. What? gosh, she looks horrible. I can't believe she's taking pictures. Fuck, she looks bad. Their daughter is a ham. Oh, she was airlifted. Holy Toledo. She's not, she's having the time of her life. She's fine. Put that oxygen on. The whole family can just spend the night in the hospital? That's incredible. The nurse is coming in, you guys. You shouldn't have taken it off. Okay, that's cute as shit. Sing it in both. Wake her up, what's going on? What the fuck happened? Call the fucking nurse. What happened? What the fuck? On her fucking birthday? Someone come and help! What happened? What happened? Oh, okay. I don't understand what happens. That doesn't solve the problem. Just saying that I love you, okay? Listen to what she's saying to you. I can't believe she's not helping at all. Like, come on. That's why I hate camping. Too many fucking bugs. It's way too cold. You have to pee outside. I'm good. And it's raining. Like, nope. No. It's time for you to pull up your pants, dude. Seriously? How? Get up! I'm sorry. Oh, come on. And this is another reason why I will never ever go camping. Ever. I don't care where you are in the world, there's always some family like this lurking around. How is Tobias not hearing all of this? Where are you? Oh, you're just watching. Go save your fucking wife. Seriously? Okay, what are you about to do? Please tell me that you're gonna go and save her. What are you looking for? A knife. Okay. Did they kill her? Where is she? Like, first of all, the dog knows that there's somebody in there, okay? Jeez. Oh my God. Stab it! Where's the wife? Did they kill her? Whose blood is that? His or the dog's? The dog's. Kill him too. Where's his wife? Is she dead? Okay, you're screwed because he has a gun. Beep. crazy. Crazy. Just as crazy as that family in fucking West Virginia. Where's his wife? They shot her. You couldn't pay me enough to go camping. Yeah, you guys need to be at a bed and breakfast, because sleeping out in the middle of the woods is stupid. What's wrong with them? That's why she didn't help you hook it up. Because you're being a dick. Why? Why would you want to, though? There's a Freedom to Roam Act in Sweden? I'm gonna have to look that up. She doesn't want to go camping! Okay, now this makes sense. Yeah, now it makes sense why she was in such a bad mood. I would be too. No wonder. No wonder she was pissed. No wonder. No wonder. No one knows where the fuck they are. Wow. And okay, first of all, her flashlight is not going to alert anyone. Your whole tent is right there. So if anyone's coming, they're going to see you anyway, with or without her flashlight. What? See? What did I just tell you? They were there all along. Where is Tobias? How is he not? Okay, there. She's right there. What the fuck? Where is he? Right fucking there, doing nothing. He's running away. Is she dead? He fucking left her there? Is she... What's going on? Why? Why is this happening? I couldn't imagine brushing my teeth in unfiltered, nasty ass lake water. Like, might as well just not brush them at all. Why don't you guys have any bottled water? Okay, so here we go again. Turn the fucking flashlight off like he told you to. Why is she still in the tent while you're at the car? How are you telling her to be quiet when the alarm is going off? Get her. Why don't you just get her in the car and drive away? Like, I don't understand what the problem is. Like, what are you doing? Just get her in the car. You've wasted all this fucking time. You know they're coming. What is happening? Seriously? You guys could have fucking left. You guys should have fucking left. Okay, this you're not making not a lick of slits. You guys could have fucking left. Why would you wait for them? You guys could have been gone. And I'm not really sure why. Run him over. Run him the fuck over. He's right in front of your car. Tobias, what are you gonna do? You're gonna let them hurt your wife again? Do something! Why? Why would you sit there and let them do this? I fucking hate you. Why? Why? You could have been gone. You're a punk. You're such a bitch ass punk. Like, you could have saved her. How long were you sitting in that fucking car? Run him over! Yep. Run him the fuck over. What are we doing, Tobias? What are we doing? What are we doing? Seriously? What are we doing? Oh, God. This guy is something else, boy. Chances are you gonna get to get this shit right, okay? Because you're starting to piss me off. Go get, take her in the car. Both of you go this time, okay? Both of you, do not leave her behind. Yeah, take her with you. Go with him. Don't fight him. Go with him. No. No, it wasn't. Get in. No! You see, he's panicking! Fucking hell. Fuck that shit! Oh my God, pull her by her fucking hair if you have to. Get in! Go. Please make it. They're not going to. They need fucking grief counseling. And he needs to slow down. At least until you get to the city. No, he can't pull over. So, you're still alive. No! Do you need to go that far off in the woods to pee? There's no one else around you. Oh, God. So fucking close. All those fucking mosquitoes. And here comes this fucking animal. Fucking hell. Okay. Where's Tobias? Did he leave her? Where's Tobias? You know what? Once your wife is dead, you should just drive the fuck off. What is this fucking... Okay. Where is he? He's not even in there. Okay, so what now? Why is there snow? What the fuck? Girl, what are you doing? Where the fuck did he go? Damn it. Where the fuck is Tobias? He didn't make it very far. Was he trying to save her by driving away? Like, what's happening? He's dead. Is he? What happened? Okay, so he's not in the car. He drove it away. Where is he though? I don't understand. How are you gonna drive with that giant rock on their gear shift, dude? Come on. Why are we getting out of the car? Seriously? You're not... Okay. Where the fuck is her husband? Why are we laying on the ground crying? I don't understand. Why are you crawling on the ground crying? Please explain to me. I'm confused. There's that fucking cat, so... That's what you're worried about is the cat? Why are we following the cat into the wilderness? Your car is right there. If this cat led her astray, I'm gonna be so mad. Where's Tobias? Wait, what the fuck? What in the fuck is going on? What? Okay, hold on. This is really quite sad. Wow, what the fuck, dudes? And he's in a cage, so, yep, he can't get out. Jeez. Wow, what in the world? Listen to him. Listen to him. What in the fuck? Get up! Oh my God, why? You're fine. No! Please get this right. What the fuck? Okay, you know what? Oh my god. Fuck your shit! He's trying to save your life! Let's go! Are they... Okay. This is a little bit stressful, okay? Because, like, how many times are we going to do this? Yeah, too bad. She'll be fine. She can take a shower. This is the song we're going to be listening to? Quit fucking with the radio and drive. God damn it. But the, what's going on? Okay, hold on, you guys. I'm not sure if this is quite over yet. It might be. Okay, you guys, this creepy little movie from Sweden. Okay, so this movie is about a family, a mom and dad and a daughter, which looks like they went to a party for an Easter celebration, and the mom ended up getting food poisoning from shellfish. And so they spend the night in the hospital. But when they woke up in the hospital, their daughter was dead. Like, there was no explanation on, you know, why she, what was her birthday. And so the dad snuck out of the room and found like a cupcake and some like a soda in the cafeteria. So they were like gonna surprise her, wake her up for her birthday, but she was dead. And so then the and for her birthday, she got this music box, but she never got a chance to open it, you know, because she died. And so 3 years later, they go on a holiday to go camping, except for the interaction between the mom and the dad is so strained that they're arguing over the littlest of things. Like, when he stops at a gas station and gets ice cream, she's not happy about the ice cream. She doesn't really want to go camping. She wants to stay in a bed and breakfast, but he's insisting on camping. And so they get to the campground, and she has to go outside in the middle of the night to go to the bathroom. And while she is outside of the tent, this crazy family assaults her, and she dies. And and they, you know, are getting ready to kill Tobias. And that's where it stops, right? And then it starts all over again from the moment where someone, the first time they were assaulted, she's like looking off the tent with a flashlight and she's looking at all the mosquitoes. She really doesn't want to go outside to go to the bathroom. And there's even a small argument there about her wanting, so like, it looks like, I don't camp. So it looks like there's a tent inside of a tent and she wanted to go to the bathroom on the outer side of the tent, not in the, like the core, but on the outer side. He's like, are you kidding? Go outside and go to the bathroom. So like the second time that it happens, he wakes up and he's like, wait a minute. And it doesn't, the third time it happens is when he's thinking, okay, I have to get this right. So it's like they're stuck in a karmic cycle. And he made me hella angry because for the first six times, I don't remember how many times they had to go through this cycle because they weren't learning what they needed to learn. He always left his wife behind and they ended up both being killed. And so at the last cycle, the last right before the Wheel of Fortune turns in their favor, he just grabs his wife and they drive away and they end up in a car accident. But in that moment, after that car accident, they realize that they are all that they have left. They're still together and their daughter lives within them. And so they take a moment and really see each other and allow themselves to grieve within one another. And then that's how the movie ends. So it was super creepy, so creepy. Especially because the family from like it's just kind of like every single scary family we see in every single movie where they're camping, like the family from, you know, U-Turn and The Hills Have Eyes and Deliverance. It's this type of family, but they're in Sweden, so it's like it's incredible. And and so the scenes with that family is just nuts, and it's just so strange because they're all like dressed really nice, and not really nice, but very like whimsical. Like, you know, I think this is just my take, that after the daughter died and she was seeing what her parents were going through, you know, she was playing with that music box that went in a circle like a carousel, and it was like she was trying to get them to see through her carousel the errors of their ways, and so until they got it right and they were able to leave that cycle behind, that karmic cycle behind them, and it looks like they're going to be starting fresh. This was really good. I didn't know what I was getting into. I'm going to give this a 3.5 stars out of 5. What I need to do is I need to do some more research on the story behind the that's another thing that I forgot to tell you. So after the daughter dies, there's a puppet show. And right before they learn their lesson, there's another puppet show. And so the puppet show is more emotional than the movie as a whole. I think when you guys watch this movie, it's on Shredder, and I think you can watch it on YouTube. After you watch the whole entire movie, the whole entire movie is told within the puppet show, which is just, it's just really interesting. The artwork is really interesting, and just the I can't believe they found the characters that looked exactly like the characters that were on the music box, down to the dog. And so what I was about to say before I interrupted my own self is I think I need to do some more research on the myth of the I'm so bad, you guys. I'm sorry. The Koko-di-Koko-da, and see if I can just get some more information on it so that I can fill in some of the stuff that's lost in translation. Again, you guys, this was out of Sweden, one of the movies that we are, and just the content that we are going to be providing for you guys this season on Horror Addicts for more cultural horror. Again, 3.5 stars out of 5. Jeez Louise, 3.5 stars out of 5. It was a really good movie. Let me know if you guys are gonna check it out and leave me some comments and let me know what you think. Okay, you guys, thanks for hanging out with me and Horror Addicts. And until our next review, ciao.